Let's hypothesize that you have sensitive data which you need to hide from the face of the earth for your own personal reasons. We don't care why you want to hide them or who they concern. We are here only to tell you the most effective ways to do that. You might be, for example, a politician who has something to hide, but thieves might intrude your home or your office looking for those classified files. So how could you hide those files from their sight? The easiest way is to buy a camouflaged or else disguised USB sticks, and hopefully the intruder won't recognize that this is a USB stick. Here are a few. The other thing that you could do is to lock your files algorithmically. That means lock your files using an encoding algorithm, such as Base64. The problem here is that you need to use that specific encoding / decoding algorithm, and if you don't write down the algorithm's name, you might forget it in time. You might forget which algorithm you used to encode your data. If you do write down which algorithm you used, or which program you used, or whatever encoding trick or compression you applied, then the intruder might be able to discover it along with the encoded message. And then there is no much of a point encoding your data. You could, of course, create your own encoding algorithm and store it somewhere, but that would complicate things even further, as you might not remember in the future where you stored your algorithm. The other way that you could hide sensitive data is place them on old, obsolete floppy disks. Floppy disks were so common in late 20th century culture that many programs continue to use the floppy disk as a save icon even today. The oldest forms of floppy disks, like the 8-inch, are extremely rare to non-existent. If you save data on such a disk, the thief might easily find it, as it will definitely draw some attention. The thief might be suspicious and intrigued to investigate the contents of them. If you save your data on the most distributed and used floppy drive, the 3.5-inch, the thief won't need any extreme effort to find a floppy drive and try out your discrete data. So I guess the most appropriate drive to use right now is the 5.25, because that disk won't intrigue an intruder so much. It will seem like a forgotten diskette. But on the other side, that ain't a such good solution, as your files are stored locally. And even if the intruder has no clue with what kind of program they can open your files, let's say that your files have a non-distinguishable ending, no zip files, no JPEG, something rare, even in that case, they can always reverse engineer your files and extract valuable info. So we are proceeding slowly to the method that makes more sense, at least according to my logic, and that method is storing data on the cloud. Cloud computing is called the on-demand availability of computer system resources, such as data storage. When you save something on the cloud, you simply save it on a remote computer. And that means that you should save somewhere the username and the password. And on a thorough research, unfortunately, the investigator will eventually be able to discover your hidden data, as he will most probably find your username and the password. In that case, the intruder cannot reverse engineer your files, as he has to gain access to your account first. So if your passcode is something that you only remember and never forget, the hacker will have a truly hard time hacking your account, if he's not able to set up a keylogger or a fake login screen or something like that on your computer. So, the best way to hide sensitive data on a budget is to store them on cassettes. The compact cassette or music cassette or tape cassette is an analog magnetic tape invented by Philips in 1963. Is what people used for decades to listen to music. What you don't probably know is that you can save your precious data on these cassettes as audio format. Imagine that you have a vintage cassette player and next to it few old rusty cassettes. Who would ever thought that there are data stored in one of those cassettes? Not even a genius like me would figure that out. When converting data to sound, the files are stored as binary using ones and zeros. In theory, you can convert any data file into WAV file, but especially text files that contain passwords can be converted to a WAV file in a blink of an eye. As you can see here, there is even a way to transcode an Excel file into a WAV file. The files here are of course not encrypted, but it is highly unlikely that the hacker will think to look for data in sound cassettes. So, the best way to hide sensitive data in 2022, which for the moment is not practical and it will sound to you very exotic, but believe me, is the most efficient and most powerful solution, and that is to steer information in DNA molecules. By comparison with all other methods, DNA storage is potentially more expensive, but also more energy efficient and longer lasting. Studies show that DNA properly encapsulated with a salt remains stable for decades. DNA doesn't require maintenance, and the best of all is that DNA can archive a staggering amount of information in an almost inconceivably small volume. Consider this: all of Facebook's data can be stored into a small seed of matter. And this might sound to you like science fiction, but it's only because you are not well informed. DNA storage technology exists today, but to make it commercial, researchers have to clear a few tiny technological hurdles around compatibility issues first, and then of course to find the correct formula on the correct timing to pass it over to the market. Compared to computers that work with binary, which works with ones and zeros, nature has empowered us with an advanced archetypal machine language, which consists of a four-letter code system instead of the two that our binary consists. So this primordial machine language, called DNA, consists of adenine, thymine, guanine and kitosine. Those four elements are the basis of all DNA structures, providing the instruction manual for rebuilding or even reshaping, I dare to say, every living thing on Earth and beyond. The technique organizes those basic elements into various arrangements, indicated by specific sequences, exactly like our computers are structured. And you can now consider ourselves, but especially me, halfway through to becoming gods. These four elements wrap in a twisted chain around each other, the familiar double helix, to form a molecule. By synthesizing DNA molecules, I mean making them from scratch, researchers have found that they can specify or write long strings of the letters A, C, G, and T, and then read those sequences back. The process is completely similar to how computers store binary information. For the moment, the method has proven to work, but the writing speed rate is a bit slow, exactly as computers were back in the 50s and the 60s, So scientists are looking for new ways to develop faster techniques, for example, with parallel operations, and it is estimated that in 20 or 30 years from now, if not sooner, the technology will become the standard way when it comes to storing data. So don't be surprised if one day in the near future, all the world's archives find a new home in seeds, in plants, or even in our own body.